At least 6 Assam police personnel were killed and 50 were injured over a sharp escalation over the age-old boundary dispute between Assam and Mizoram on July 26th. Although there have been several clashes arising out of the interstate dispute between various states of the Northeast, the recent disputes between Assam and Mizoram culminated in violence, which has rarely happened before.
Most of the states of Northeast that we have today were in Assam at some point of time, including Arunachal Pradesh, Mizoram, Nagaland, other states. Even Manipur was at a point of time in the state in which all these states later on broke away and became union territories, later on became a full state. The state of Mizoram that we have today separated from Assam in 1972. It became a full-fledged state in the 1980s. So since then, there was a pending boundary dispute between these two states, Assam claiming that it had some large tracts of plain lands and sloping lands in its own territory, Mizoram, of course, denying the claim. So this whole thing had to start from a series of boundary demarcations. Right. So as we know, the Northeast had mostly been, as a Northeastern Frontier Agency was one of the major areas in the British colonial regime, excluding Assam, of course. So in those times, in 1875, the demarcation was done by the then rulers, the colonial rulers. That demarcation forms the mainstay of the entire logic of demarcation favored by the Mizoram authorities, because they say in 1875 they were consulted. At that time, what the Mizoram of course was in the separate state, what they had, what we call today as the Lushai Hills Authority. Fast forward to 1933, what happened is that a tri-junction between Lushai Hills, which is today Mizoram, the Kachar district of Assam, which is the southern part of Assam, and that we have Manipur. Those three parts were separately demarcated in the 1933 demarcation. But the Mizos don't accept this demarcation. They feel that it is an imposed demarcation, imposed, cartographic division, because their authorities were not, purportedly they were not consulted at the time. So according to Mizo leaders, the only acceptable boundary is the inner line of 1875 as per the BFR Act. The Mizo government, most of the political parties of Mizoram, several NGOs and civil societies of the state, they submitted a memorandum to the Prime Minister's office, to Prime Minister Narendra Modi in 2018. The same memorandum was submitted to the Home Minister Amit Shah when a meeting was held in Shillong a couple of days back. So the memorandum categorically says that areas like Kachar Ziyong, Klangnuam, Lala Bazar, Banga Bazar, which was earlier they claim were in Mizoram, now have been unreasonably excluded in the 1933 demarcation. And they feel that sloping lands, plain lands, which are favorable for Mizos for settled cultivation, right, those were excluded from the area. But since no resolution has been reached yet, the government of India has asked them to maintain status quo till further decision. And with the intervention of Home Minister Amit Shah, the issue has now been put to rest, and security transgressions in this contested boundary have now been withdrawn. It's not like the issue, the whole boundary dispute blew up yesterday or day before yesterday. It is a series of small incidents going on. So one of the main points that I have found is that perhaps Mizoram feels they are not sufficiently taken into consultation and confidence when Assam comes to discuss these issues. As far as Assam is concerned, Assam feels that constructing any kind of structure, even for the military or paramilitary, near these contested boundaries is a transgression of the status quo understanding between the two states. And the final thing is that Assam feels a section of civilians from Mizoram side have been interfering in this whole official business, and they allegedly attacked the Assam government officials when they went in. As we know, unfortunately, 5 people have been killed, 5 senior, including senior police officials of Assam police have been killed in this incident. Over 50 have been injured. So this whole issue, I think, is now waiting and it is headed for a peaceful and amicable resolution by the government of India's intervention. So whenever these incidents, incidents of violence and clashes break out in the interstate boundary, Mizoram has alleged that on the Assam side, there is an economic blockade on the national highway. And since this is the only lifeline for Mizoram, it affects their economy, it affects their, pricing of essential goods, and life becomes, normal life is disturbed in that state. I think, including Assam itself, these states of Northeast need to discuss among themselves and find an amicable solution, but make sure that till that solution is reached, normalcy in these states and, public life is not hampered. Because this is a technical, debate between governments, but common people should not suffer for that.